This is Brian Schwartz from KindleExpert.com. I know many of you who I do conversions for want to be able to preview your books on a Kindle, but you don't yet own a Kindle. So I'm going to show you how you can still review the book as if you did own the Kindle. Now, this only works for the PC, unfortunately, but I want you to go over to my KindleExpert.com website, go into my Resources tab, and go down to the Kindle Emulator for PC link. And this is going to bring up a dialog box in a second that says, do you want to open or save this file? You want to go ahead and save this file on your computer and then run it. It's an executable and it'll install the Kindle emulator on your computer. Now, I've already done that, so I'm going to cancel out of here. Once you do, you're going to get this looking program here, which looks just like an actual Kindle. We're going to open up the book. Now, I sent you a .mobi file, most likely, or a .prc file, and you want to open that from within here. So you want to open book and go ahead and open the Mobi file I provided. And what it'll do is convert to Kindle, and you can start to review it here as if you had a Kindle. You can go to the cover. You can look at the table of contents. The table of contents is linked. Everything works with the exception of hyperlinks. They don't support hyperlinks. If it's underlined, it's going to be a hyperlink to your website, so you can rest assured. But you can go through here and make sure it looks the way you want it to. Everything looks good. This is going to look exactly how it would on a Kindle if this is the default settings. Now you can change the font size. So for example, anybody who owns a Kindle can change the font size to whatever they want. You can change the device. So if you want to see what it looks like, for example, for the Kindle app for the iPad, this is kind of handy. This is really helpful. You can see here, this is what people who have an iPad are going to see. Now it's in full color. So this is one of the questions that often comes up. Well, Brian, how do I load this on my iPad? I want to see what this looks like on the iPad. If you have the Kindle app for the iPad, this is how it's going to look. You notice the pictures that are in full color will come in full color. And again, I've changed the font size. This is probably more typical, I think size 3. Again, it's up to the person. If you want to see what it looks like on a Kindle DX, which is that full-size Kindle device that I think are going to start getting more popular, you can do that as well. And then the popular Kindle for iPhone, as you can see now, it's going to shrink it down into the size of an iPhone. And as you go through here, you'll notice that the text essentially is scaled per the screen size and per the font size that the person chooses. So you really can't dictate how much text exists on each screen because you have no way of knowing what screen size they're going to use. You have no idea of knowing what font size they prefer to read in. Some people may prefer the small font. Others may prefer a larger font. Well, when you do a larger font, obviously you're going to spill text over to additional pages. That wouldn't be the case when you use a smaller font. See, now it's going to have everything here. So hopefully that helps you review the books that I send you. Make sure that everything's navigatable. You know, the go-to table of contents, this should all be valid. You can check this out. Table of contents, go to cover, and everything that you intended. Again, depending on the device. Now, I really recommend and prefer to format books for the Kindle, the actual Kindle reader. This is what the majority of people are going to be buying your book, are going to be using, and this is how I optimize your book first and foremost, because this is how the majority of your readers are going to get this book. So again, I hope that was helpful. Back to how you do this, go back to KindleExpert.com, click on resources, click on Kindle Emulator for PC, install that. Once you've installed that, you can go ahead and open the book from wherever you saved it on your computer. Make sure you open the Mobi file, and you're going to be good to go. Thanks so much. Have a great day.